Hello, my beautiful Leo friends. How are you today? 2022 is here, and you are going to have an abundant, incredibly prosperous, successful year ahead of you. There are tremendous energies working beneath the surface right now. The overall energy for the year, Leo, is you are close to achieving your goal. We see that you've been working very diligently and you're carrying in a work ethic, tiny triumphs, stepping through the day, taking your authority to take care of everything that you can actively take care of, not being overly concerned about what's happening, just using a very strong, almost an earthy energy, like with a Virgo overlay to this year. When we look at the energy of the Lady of the Forest, the Lady and the Lord of the Forest are the energies that manifest everything. It would be like maybe a little bit the equivalent of the Emperor and the Empress, that the Lady of the Forest dreams big, fantasizes, indicates what really needs to happen, and then hands it over to the Lord to actually do the work. And what we're seeing here is your balance of masculine and feminine energy is profoundly powerful, that you have been taking this in stride for the past year, and you've been manifesting because of it. What we see also here is a message from Spirit that's telling you that even though there are times that you're working alone a great deal, as we see in the Moon card, that you are never, never alone. The Otter Spirit is all about the fact that you have surrounded yourself with people who truly love you, want to have fun with you, are playful with you, and are there to support you. When we look at the energy of embracing enthusiasm, shout to the heavens with happiness, because what is happening this year for you is that you are on the precipice of achieving a goal that looks like it has been at least several years in the making. When we look at how you present yourself this year, how you appear to others is very mysterious. This is the rulership of the planet Neptune. We have Jupiter in Pisces right now. It's like howling at the moon. You're so in touch. I feel as though many of you are doing a lot of lucid dreaming. Many of you are allowing your subconscious mind to drive your actions and really following your intuition. When we look at you in all partnerships this year, whether they be marriage, business, doctors, lawyers, realtors, financial advisors, we see the Queen of Cups, people who truly have your best interest at heart. Again, rulership of Cancer. You know, the moon energy is underlying this energy. Many of you may choose, and for those of you who are married, you may have a wife or a husband who is very intuitive. Maybe somebody with Cancer in their chart, in their astrology chart, somebody who loves you profoundly, who wants to nurture you, and is very comfortable with you in this intuitive energy. As we look at your financial well-being, your earned income, we see that your skill set is at the top of the world. The World card is Saturn. It rules the 10th house of career. What we see is success. Many people really like to say tarot readers online, you know, are very accurate in that you are going to a new cycle, but you go there as quote unquote, the winner of the Academy Award for whatever you do. So we're seeing this wild success and recognition taking place in your outward manifestation of a great ability to earn a lot of money, to create a lot of investments, to create what you want to manifest in your material life, in relationships. Everything that you dream of, everything that you hold near and dear to your heart has a Taurus overlay. So what we see is absolute success here. You know, you've already been told by spirit that you are very close to achieving the goal. When I look at the timing of the World card, I would say your timing for this success would most likely come 20 weeks into the year or just before the halfway mark in June. So I would say May would be a time that you are very likely to bring something, a dearly beloved goal, to fruition. When we look at your eighth house of investments, I don't know exactly what you're investing in. It very clearly looks like you have been. We see the Empress, abundance, maturity, 401ks, inheritances, whether they be through hard work, something you've inherited through your own endeavor, an inheritance that somebody leaves you, the goodwill or the inheritance of people around you who trust you. We see that your 401k, your pension, whatever it is that you've invested in, it's Scorpio energy. It's something that is coming to fruition in a grand way this year. There is a big payoff, literally and figuratively, in your happiness. As we look at your neighborhood, contracts, brothers, sisters, you know, the people who are around you in your immediate vicinity understand that you are working hard. They understand that sometimes you're not always available to hang out or, you know, to just have fun. They see you very much and they're supporting you. Your friends, your siblings, your neighborhood. It's a very good place that you've chosen to be right now in the outer world. It looks as though you're also with the Seven of Coins. You've made this investment. It's about to pay off, okay? So this investment is at the Seven of Pentacles, but you'll get to the Ten of Pentacles. When we look at the energy of the ninth house for you, we are looking at the Three of Wands. Your ships have come in. For some of you, it can literally mean, with the Three of Wands, it's Sagittarius energy. It literally means in the ninth house of Sagittarius. What we see here for you with the Three of Wands is that you've taken the action, which is Aries, to manifest the ships that have arrived in the harbor. So what we see is in legal matters, and if you're in the broadcasting industry, if you're in publishing, this would mean like, well, your book publishes this year. It means that whatever you've been working on, all of this sort of mysterious energy in which you've kept to yourself and just put your nose down, you know, and you've really just paid attention to the details, we see it manifesting for you in ways in which you could receive recognition, acclaim, you could become a teacher. What we see is, especially if you are interested in possibly properties or places around the globe, this does indicate that you may make an investment in a foreign country or a place that could be very far away from you, up to 3,000 miles away. Could be longer, could be, you know, around the globe, as I said. But this is a house of long distance travel, different cultures, ethnicities, it's higher education. Some of you may win a scholarship, you may go back to school, you could be asked to teach, but this is absolute success. When we get the Three of Wands, you know you've already chosen your path and you are manifesting the results now. We also see in the fourth house, the house of nurturance, of family, of history, of legacy, the Fool card. We see this sort of dragon or dinosaur beneath the surface, wiggling this flower up here, and it's a Fool card. And what we're seeing is that there are people around you from your family who absolutely adore you. They know what you're capable of. But what we also see is someone or something or an entity from your history trying to sort of seduce you into smelling the flower and not understanding what goes with it. So as I read this, for those of you who are from different countries, you know, you're living in different countries than your family of origin, it does say that there could be pitfalls about your adventures if you fall into old stereotypes or ways of thinking. So what we're seeing here is that this is it's a fool card, it's a new adventure, but with it, paired with it in your 10th house of career, is this absolutely feminine empress, the feminine emperor card, which is unique to this deck. So when we see this, we look and see all this ability in your career, in your 10th house. You have mastered your skill set. We see it with the World card. We see it with the Empress. We see it with the other cards that are telling us the amount of success that you will have this year, Leo. So what we're actually saying is that you could fall into an old rut or a way of thinking. It might be fear-based. So what we see is that you step beyond that. You're very much in the mode of manifesting with the Lady of the Forest. It also looks as though, as much as you might love some of the people around you that might not understand what you're doing, that you're able to, you know, just stick, you're able to ignore outside distractions, Two of Swords. So for any creative endeavor, any endeavor in which your children are involved, or any romance, you are really keeping your own counsel. The Two of Swords says, hey, I don't need to hear any opinions. I'm really good on my own. I'm over here. I'm not going to look at things the way you do anyway, because what we see with you is that you have circumstances around you in which you are increasing your knowledge. So you're not staying in this sort of historical, you know, old-fashioned sort of fear-based thinking. You're saying, nope, cutting myself off from that, because I am too busy learning everything that I need to know to get from the Eight of Pentacles to the Nine and the Ten of Pentacles. It's Virgo energy. It's doing the work. It's very much aligned with this interesting card of tiny triumphs, you know, really taking care of business one step at a time, just taking the jobs and juggling them and doing what you can in small increments, and trusting that you have this incredible knowledge and skill set to pull you through, because you absolutely do, and you know you do. So what we see also for your sixth house of health, everyday life, day in, day out, Page of Wands. You're being very playful, Leo. You're really having a lot of fun investigating things, learning new things. Pages are all about messages. It looks as though you are taking the leap of faith into the future, trusting yourself, trusting your ability to navigate the very, very tricky waters of success. And what we see here is that even though you're very serene on the surface, we see that, you know, there's some churning water here that's going on. And what we see you doing, Leo, is really staying, you know, on top of your game. We have Pisces energy here. We have Scorpio energy here. We have Cancerian energy here. So what we see is a triad of balancing your emotions, the ability to transcend with a skill set, to manifest the Empress abundance that you want. You've been doing what you've been doing probably for some time, and you're just not going to fall into any traps. You are certainly ignoring that which is a distraction, and you are moving ahead to a success level with this Empress in your house of abundance and the World card in your everything that you value and achieving it. This year, your dreams will actually come to fruition. You are in the final cycle of a building and manifestation cycle in the year 2022. Let's look and see what the energy here is that could challenge you for the year. It might not, though. this is a shadow deck. And so when we look at shadow work, we say, you know, what does Leo need to know that they might not currently be aware of? So as a reader, I'm going to flip the cards and let you know. Ace of Wands, you are with a Page of Wands. It makes such sense. You're throwing caution to the winds. You're going into a brand new cycle in your life. As you finish off this beautiful manifestation, you're going to go into this energy. And the Ace of Wands is the energy of fire sign. And so we see you with a new beginning. Two of Coins, you're going to have two different options. Many of you are going to balance two different incomes, two different investment sources, but you are certainly going to keep two different streams of income alive. We see the Knight of Wands, you're moving around. You're really taking those chances. You are on a mission. Knights are always on a mission. You're not going to settle into your new investment immediately. You're going to scope everything out. You're going to try it on for size. The Hanged Man Pisces energy is all about just trusting your intuition. The Scorpio energy for the eighth house, which is where you have all of this abundance. We also see that for those of you who are married, you could have a spouse who brings a lot of abundance into the relationship in the way of inheritance or investment or, you know, a job, whatever, however this person, your person, would inherit. Now, what we get is Temperance, beautiful Sagittarius, powerful Sagittarius energy here for you with the Knight of Wands and Temperance. You are going to stay very balanced, very grounded. You are in no rush. You're looking at everything from a different perspective. You are open to hearing all of the information that you hear, and you are going to make an absolutely great choice with the Temperance card. When we look at the pursuit of your happiness, the Five of Cups tells me that in the last year, you have not spent as much time with the people that you love that you would like to spend. The Daughter of Cups is the energy that says, I want to be more playful. I want to enjoy life a little bit more. I want to tap in to some sort of energy like dancing or theater or a way of expressing yourself that you really haven't done. And I'm getting the Sun card, the ruler of the fifth house on the astrology chart. Great happiness. You seem to be meeting or you seem to be coming into contact with a Daughter of Cups energy. Somebody who really knows how to be happy. They share that with you. It could be a new love interest. It could be a new beginning in love. And look at this, your ships have arrived. So for your love life, even though it appears that you're not really out looking for anyone, we see rock star status, a relationship that represents everything that you've ever wanted after a long period, even up to 5 years of really feeling that you were alone and working, you know, in an environment where you were just stepping forward, building your success, and not getting the same emotional gratification that you would like. Look at this, a star card. The star card is hopes and dreams for love coming true. The literal interpretation from the Tarot. So Leo, I am so excited for you this year. It's an amazing year. You have been working. You have been alone. You have been going through a lot of your manifestation without complaint, with great majesty, with great skill, with great authority, the respect of others. And we see a wonderful year of manifesting virtually everything that you're, that inner source of who you are really desires most. Sending you love from Chicago. Send me some back and tell me where you're watching this video from. Happy New Year, Leo. Take care. Bye-bye.